it's a big milestone. We had this as a goal for a very long time, and then here we are, right? But let me tell you, this feeling will never go away. Bottle it up. I don't know, think of the biggest container you can imagine. Hold it there. Whenever you feel down or you want to stop, go back to the container, drink from it. Remember why you made this choice. Like, get driven internally, okay? I just want to start off on that note because I know the energy in this room is really good. I know that people are really trying to frighten you guys, all of us included. But you guys come in with a sort of energy that some of us have maybe forgotten. We all worked very hard to get here to this place. So don't ever let it go. Don't ever forget why you applied, why you took the effort to, you know, come and write that exam, make it through the interview, convince and beg to be here, right? So I joined this program with 15 years of work experience. I had an MBA job. So I was doing a product strategy role in the US for most of my life. And I came in here with a 5-month-old baby. So the day I came to write my exam, I literally left my child at home, and I have an older son as well. And in me, you guys see study life integration. They're sitting right here disturbing all of us. So I just want to call that out to say that anybody can do this program if they set their mind to it and if they see the value in doing this for themselves. This, like, deciding to take this time to do this program was a very selfish decision on my part, but one that was widely supported by everybody in my family, outside of my family as well. So the day I got the admit and I posted about it, maybe I took a picture on the inaugural function like this a couple of years ago, I got a call from the US, which is where I had most of my work experience. I actually had many calls and people congratulating me, saying that hey, we heard that you got into the Ivy League of India. So don't ever forget that this brand value is mind-blowing. People that you haven't met, you are going to meet in the future, will know this and will value you. Even though you carry a lot of merit on your own, the fact that you made it here and you are going to make something of yourself through this program is going to speak for itself. So I think folks have covered so much on what you need to do to prepare. I just want to say that there is no such thing called balance. I have no balance. I have zero balance in my life. The minute I sit here to talk to you guys, I have let them off on their own, but I've handed them over to someone I trust and care about, and I know that my kids are being taken care of, and I did that every single weekend that I was at the program, and I had family members and friends helping us out. Actually, my husband and I both took this program. So it was good and bad, because that was the only time we got to socialize without the kids and family. But we didn't sit together in class and never in the same team. But we had the opportunity to interact on the car rides. Because imagine if one of us had taken the course, we wouldn't have seen each other these 2 years, literally, with the jobs and other pressures. So I see that as a pro, because I really got to spend some quality time with him. Having said that, women with young children or starting out in their early stage of career or whatever, you guys can do it. Don't overthink it, don't rationalize it, don't try to think that you have to be perfect in everything, because none of us are perfect, nobody is perfect. So just start, do your best, show up. Something that I've learned in my life is you need to show up if you want to win the reward for something. And you know your self-worth only when you start showing up and you start practicing your craft. So I have learned from my peers what my good qualities are. For instance, I did not know that I can do slides well till my friends pointed it to me in my teamwork, in my group work. They said, you're good with slides and presentation. You focus on that. We'll start putting the content together. I actually did not know that. So then we started cross-pollinating our different skills, and they learned from me and I learned from them. So then different people, there was a doctor in my batch, in my cohort. There is an auditor in my cohort. There is a psychology major. Sometimes when I interact with them, I learn about how their mind works. Not like, for instance, someone from the psychology major may not be analytical the way you are. You learn to appreciate their differences and their strengths, and then to play with that. So that was a very good learning. I wouldn't go so far as to say take a new team every for every project, but try to talk to everybody. I mean, now we are all in term 9 and we know each other really well. But if you get to know them sooner, then you get to play along much better. Another thing is, I think Nanda sir pointed it out very well in the last conversation, the last speech that he gave. If you have a problem that you're dying to solve in your organization or in general, take that with you to every class, maybe make notes or think about that and how it applies. Try to make the connections, because like he said rightly, when you're doing your industry project, those insights will be very deeply valuable. And sometimes when you're trying to think about those kind of things within a span of a few days or a week, you may not, you know, those things may not click. But every class, a lot of times when I go back home to pick up my, go back wherever I've dropped them to pick them up after class, my relatives, they remark that I'm glowing after the class. You know, you would expect to be tired. You've been busy all week and then you go to class, sit down, and then when you're back home, my mom always says that I'm glowing. It's because the intellectual stimulation is actually something that we all enjoy. That's the reason we are sitting here, right? And you are sitting here with like-minded people. Even at work, you may not find people who are like you, who have similar preferences. So despite all your differences, you will find that there is more in common with each other. You guys have aligned purposes. So use that to the core. And like I said, don't get hung up on who's doing what and, you know, that kind of stuff. I mean, treat it as not as a program, but more like work. If you treat it as a job, then you're more likely to succeed. Because so much more is at stake. Every project, every case, treat it as an assignment at work. You will want your boss to think well of you, right? Will you go and just keep complaining about your subordinate or your peer? So try to get them to work, learn how you can creatively engage them. As a product manager, I have a lot of experience trying to influence indirectly. I have no real power over my engineering team or my QA team. Nobody cares, but I'm responsible for my releases, for my software releases. I don't know if people understand the software parlance here, but I'm pretty much responsible for it. If the product fails at launch, I'm on the line. I have P&L responsibility. So the more you learn those kind of skills, the better your success will be in your career as well. So use these 2 years to shape those skills. I mean, it's easy to be the whiny complainer. I'm also a complainer. I complain all the time. But you know, try to channelize that energy. Do what you need to do. Maybe work hard, party hard. Whatever works for you. Go inside yourself. Think about how to cope. I recently read a book where they said on the night before a very difficult engagement, if you can spend a few minutes thinking about what are the worst things that are likely to happen. You can just process that. You don't need to have answers, but think it through. It's much easier to handle the next day, even if you don't have all the answers. So, I mean, read up books that help you come up with your own plan. Other than that, I would say compartmentalize and, try your best, but it doesn't matter. This MBA is not going to fetch you anything other than what you really want. And what are you going to do with it at the end of the day is really what is important. So, go into this with this mindset. You already have a win. You already won something. Use that positive energy. Think about your next plan. Start making your next plans. Work towards that, and I think we'll all be successful. Thank you.